There was a crash. You and the kids died. Initiate. I've brought you back.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So, Replicas is a film that obviously poses many moral and ethical questions about, you know, the natural order of things. And I'm curious if the technology in this film were available to you both, if you would take advantage of it to either, you know, make yourselves immortal or someone you know.
I think definitely someone you know dying, you would want to keep them around.
I know I'd want to, but should I? And then I'm taking away their choice.
The best thing you said was, what age are you going to bring them back
at? Oh, yeah, what are you going to come back
yeah,
as?
What age yeah. did they come back as?
Whatever age you would prefer.
Is it up to him? Because then he's really God. It should be up
well,
to them.
Well, it should be up
yeah,
to
but
them,
can, but what if they
dead,
don't want to come
so
back?
So it technically is up to him, you know?
What if they're, like, in a better place?
They don't yeah, want what if they are in a better place? You're bringing them back to hell.
Well, let's kind of, you know, another character you played, John Wick. You know, how would John Wick use that? Because obviously he's suffered some travel. Yeah, right?
No.
Sorry.
He's
a wonderful man.
I think because so much about what John Wick is about with that character is about free agency, that he would not make that assumption for his wife. Or unless they pre-spoke about it,
uh-huh.
and then she had agreed, then he would do it.
Right. Because he's got a little bit of a conscience to him, you know? He doesn't
yeah.
want to just go, he left that
He'd
life
He'd have to have
his...
an understanding with her
do
before
Do you not
he
think William
that.
Has a conscience?
He does to an extent, but that's part of, that's the scientific, that was the part of the thing that I was trying to kind of, exactly, he doesn't, that's where he's kind of selfish in that, and that's where he kind of disconnects. That's why he's kind of the Frankensteinian impulse of just my desire, my wish, my love, you know, but it's for science. Remember, that was part of the story.
Right,
it's like
right.
when the Thomas Middleditch character's like, wait, so is this, you're talking about your the science thing that you have to break through, not your family.
Right,
but he's
right.
like, no, it works for both. Don't you get it?
Hey, Dad.
Morning, William.
Morning.
Alice, I actually have a question for you because I am a huge fan of the character Mary Walker from Iron Fist Season 2. I thought she was like my favorite part about that season. And so being a character with split personalities, how do you get into that mindset of like both halves? What's your process kind of like? Is it difficult? Or?
That was very difficult, that
yeah,
character,
yeah.
yeah, because there isn't really a side of me that enjoys killing.
Uh-huh.
Oftentimes you play a part of you, a part that you can really find these truths, love in yourself, you can find anger, but finding the truth in yourself that really enjoys killing is a different thing to access, and so I found it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, of course you did.
Yeah, I mean, the performance was excellent.
I
yeah.
found it. Yeah,
of course
it was
you
there.
Did.
Turns out, but it was both difficult but and a joy. Because
mm-hmm.
if you ever discover anything else in life, it's a joy, right? So mm-hmm. I discovered a new side of things, and it was a joy.
I'm Death.
We stole millions of dollars worth of bionic equipment.
I hope you're ready to go to jail.
Those three subjects are our property.
I didn't define every natural law there is, just to lose you again.
A question for you both, but kind of starting with you, because you obviously are known for your extensive work in stunt choreography and doing your own stunts.
I don't do my own stunts.
Well,
sometimes
right?
What do you
I
mean?
Never do, I
You're
don't
kidding
do stunts.
Me? You drove around.
No, but that's not a stunt.
That
if I can
stunt.
Do it, it's not a stunt.
No, it was a stunt.
It's not.
Well, that's fair. I mean, yeah, fair enough. So, you know, with films really pushing the boundaries in terms of fight choreography and stunt choreography, like obviously the John Wick films, Mission Impossible, Mad Max. Historically, stunt ensembles have not been recognized at the Academy Awards. Do you see that potentially changing in the near future? Because there's been a massive push from, like, you know, Tom Cruise, Christopher McQuarrie lately. And so,
oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if it, I mean, maybe it would be in part of the science aspect of it. I don't know if it would become mainstream show, but maybe.
They were in the weren't they nominated in the Globes or the SAG?
They were nominated at the SAG, yeah. The
yeah.
SAG does acknowledge them, but I'm just curious as to what has to be done to kind
I
of...
I don't know, in the big show?
Yeah.
In the big show?
I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. I'd keep watching if that was an award.
Well, absolutely. I mean, you know, yeah. You've got the choreography you're doing in the John Wick films.
It would be cool if it really introduced some of the people behind the camera.
Yeah, just kind of like shedding some light on them who don't necessarily get time.
Instead of having other performers go, I did all my own stunts.
That's never true, is it?
Yeah, for sure. Well, thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it. It was great.
Thank you.
Congratulations on the film.
How could you do that?